Hello friends, welcome again, and this is my new project, Student Grading System, and I have developed this project in PHP and MySQL. The version for the PHP I am using is the PHP version 7 and MySQL version is 5.6. Also, I am running this project on the XAMPP server, but if you have different PHP server like XAMPP, then you can easily configure this project on the XAMPP server too. If you are using the Linux, then you can run this project on the LAMP stack. For Mac, you can install XAMPP or you can configure this project on the MAMP stack, right? So these are the technologies, right? Server-side technologies and the database. For front-end, I have used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Some of the jQuery library also I have used, like for form validations and creating sliders, creating drop-downs, integration of the date calendar plugins. I have used the jQuery plugins, right? So these all technology stacks I have used for developing this project, the student grading system. So let's start with the functionality, go through that what we have implemented in this project in student grading system, right? So let's start. So this is the home page of the project, and one more thing, this is a major project where teacher and student both can log in, and student can see their grades, and teacher can log in and submit their grades and marks, right? So let's start. So this is the home page of the project. You can see this is a simple home page and it's a bootstrap theme. So you can if you open this project in mobile app or the tab, then UI will not be distorted and the screen size will fit according to the screen size of that device, right? So this is the about page and this is a static page. There is nothing dynamic on it. This is a contact us page and this is a static page, and this you can see this is the map coming here, and it's a real Google map. And if you have internet connection, then after it, that this map will be loaded, else it will not load. So this is a teacher login from where teacher can log in, and after that teacher can perform certain operations, right? So the user credential is teacher and the password is test. Once teacher logs inside the system, then teacher will be able to see these things. So first one is the add class. He will be able to add the class. From here he will be able to add the classes, right? The second one is the add marks. From here teacher can add the marks of the student, right? So here this is the drop down where exam type, and after that exam, and then student roll number he will select, student semester he will select, and the subject, right? And written marks, practical marks, and descriptions, right? Once you click on the save marks, then this all details will be saved inside the table, right? So this is the add class, this is the add marks. Here in the report section, this is the class report from where teacher will be able to see all of the classes what he has added, right? If he want to edit, just click on the edit and edit the record and submit it, right? The second one is the search report result. From here teacher can search the result of the student, right? This is the student report. All of the students who has added by teacher will be displayed here. Even let's see the result of the student first. So teacher has added some of the marks for this student, then this roll number, I am going on the search result, and this is the final year exam, submit, search result. You can see this is the search result page. It will be rendered on the different page, but it will show you the result page, right? Okay, so this is the dashboard. So add class, I already explained you, this is the class report, student report, search results, add marks, and after that this is a my account section from where teacher will be updating his account details, right? And the last one is the logout. Once teacher clicks on the logout, then above administrative menu will not be displayed because this is session driven. It renders according to the session, right? Once you click on the logout, then session will be destroyed. So you can see the above menu is not coming, right? If teacher login again, then the menu will come. You can see menu is coming, right? And it will render according to the session and the permission level. Now I am going to login as a student. So the user ID is student and the password is test. Once a student search login inside the system, he will be able to search the result only, right? He can select the exam, and after that he can enter the roll number and click on the search result. Once you click on the search result, he will get this page, right? He will get this page. So once you click on the result, then he will get the page, right? That page is opening in different window. That's why it is not recorded, right? But he will get the result page here, right? And if from here he will be able to log out, right? You can see the search result is not displaying, right? So this is a basic level project where a student can log in and search result. Teacher will be able to log in and teacher can add the classes, add the marks, add the subjects, and after that he will be able to add the result of the students, right? And he can also search the results, right? So this all functionalities I have developed inside this project. But if you need more functionality in this project, if you want any enhancement, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate the changes. I will make this project more better and better according to requirements. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest projects videos on the latest technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.